heavyweight division to start off the night here on Before the Bell. Adam Stewart in the black trunks. He weighed in at 234 pounds, same as his last fight. A first-round knockout against Carlos Barnett back in November. Davey in the gold trunks, weighed in at 223.9. Potential future at Bridgerweight has been something that he's been thinking about, but here he's going to take any opportunity, any quality opportunity that's presented to him. Again, we're joined by Chris Algieri and Joshua Boazzi here Before the Bell. I'm Justin Shackle, and you have Adam Stewart, the Phoenix native. I'm sure he has a large crowd of support here at the Footprint Center. 12 wins, one loss, one draw with 8 knockouts.
Right away, you see the differing styles between the two. Stewart fighting much longer, taller, using his hands to kind of walk his man down. Davey more athletic, using head movement and working on the inside.
As Stewart, a former tackle playing college football, says that really helps him in terms of serving him well, moving around with heavyweights. And he surprises a lot of people with his speed. Feels like he has a snapping jab. You see one example of that punch right there.
I personally love it when I see football players making the transition to boxing. Taking that those years of training, the athleticism, the explosiveness to the heavyweight division is nothing but exciting.
He's won 4 straight fights since suffering that first pro loss to Helaman Olguin in June of 2020. And Stewart going for his 5th straight victory. Stewart, 32 years of age. Davies, 35. Standing at 6'4". He lands a clean shot there to Stewart. Less than a minute to go in the opening round. Not too often you're 6'4 and fighting opponents taller than you. What are some things, Josh, that Davey may have to look out for as he faces a taller opponent?
I think straight away being the ring fighter, round one, I want to let the guy know that this is your hometown. But I'm going to make sure there's a lot more ease of us going against you than there is for me. But again, a taller fighter has got to move the head, which I'm sure he'll move it as the round progresses on. But he seems comfortable. He's supposed to start from now, but he seems comfortable.
And Davey evading a wide looping left hook moments ago from Stewart.
Yeah, Davey's showing some tricky moves in there, switching sides, threw a nice counter right hand earlier in the round, throwing right hooks from the side as well. There's another tricky shot over the top.
Smacking left hand. And that's the sound of the bell for round one. Let's take a look at some of the action from round one.
And you see Davey looks like he's using his athleticism, his head movement to get inside of the taller man, trying to counter him on the way there. He threw that big right hand, got his head offline, just missed with that shot, but he's got the right idea.
Alvin Davey, nicknamed Gorgeous Al. He says his nickname comes from having a gorgeous jab, and it wasn't just given him by friends or family members. He had a national Golden Gloves coach approach him, and he gave him that nickname. He said, "Your jab is gorgeous." Here we go with the start of round two, scheduled for 6 between Adam Stewart and Alvin Davey. The action kicking us off here on Before the Bell, the first matchroom show of 2022 in Phoenix, Arizona. How tough is it, guys, to try your hardest not to overcompensate and not try to really go out of your way to impress when you're fighting in your hometown?
It's a lot of pressure. It can be. You land shots that may not have landed clean, but everyone's screaming. You might think, oh, I've landed here. But as Chris would confirm, you have to be controlled. Know within yourself what you're doing, how you're going about it. Don't feed in too much to what the crowd is doing, but to an extent, you have to entertain them.
It's a 3-punch combo from Stewart, backing up Davey.
I think Stewart is doing a good job of slowing the pace. He's the bigger man. He's controlling the center of the ring. He's not being too busy. He's not overextending himself. He's just looking for the perfect shots.
Timing it up with the double jab. Adam Stewart, about a year removed from quitting his full-time job and focusing on boxing full-time. He's an AC construction worker. Figures, you live in Arizona, you're always going to have that job in your back pocket. Now is the time to capitalize on his prime in the sport of boxing. Davey being warned for grabbing the back of Stewart's head.
Good attempt there. Good attempt there by Stewart, trying to counter with that right hand over the top. He's starting to seem like he's trying to get the timing of Davey right now.
Yeah, the get-to-know-you round may be extended here in round number two. That was scheduled for six. Davey trying to work the body at close range, and Stewart backs him up.
Good try there by Davey. That overhand right. Good move against a taller opponent as they rush in. And once again, turn southpaw. Eats a jab.
One thing he's doing well, guys, is that he's not standing still. You can see Davis is always moving. He's realized that the Stewart is the bigger man. If he stands still, he could be in trouble. So he's only little steps, not too much, but just making Stewart readjust every time.
Good connection there from Stewart in the final seconds of round number two.
You see a couple right hands from Stewart over the top, using that size advantage, trying to cut off the ring from Davey as he moves around. There's Davey trying to counter him with that overhand right. Good timing on that shot. Nice stiff jab there from Stewart at the end of the round.
Josh, from what you've seen with the samples of jab from Adam Stewart, could he stand to be throwing a lot more?
Yeah, I think, like Chris said, he's taking center. He knows that he's not going to work at a higher work rate. He slowed the pace down. It's going to suit him. For me, I say it's up to Davis to kind of step things up, make a bit more happen. He's the smaller man. I'm sure he can pick up the errors that Stewart will make.
Here's round three between Adam Stewart and Alvin Davey. Stewart in the black trunks. Davey sporting the gold trunks. Scheduled for six. Here on the Before the Bell undercard, ahead of Quadras Rodriguez later tonight for the WBC 115-pound title.
Seems like both men are starting this round with a little more energy than the first two. I believe that feeling out process is behind them now.
The action could be picking up here 30 seconds into round number three. A counter lead left from Davey. And a big shot coming in from the right side by Stewart. Davey says no, it did not make an impact, but usually when you shake your head, it did, in fact, rattle you just a bit.
Whether it did or it didn't, not a lot is happening in these rounds, so any flurries by Stewart is going to win him those moments.
We haven't seen either fighter really string together too many combos so far.
Stewart has a decent jab when he lets it go. He's been able to find a good home for that the last two rounds.
Big overhand left misses from Davey. Is it wise facing a taller fighter for Davey to kind of have that front hand dropped?
It's dangerous when you have a long guy with a long right hand the way Stewart does to hang out on that right side the way he is. You're not always going to be able to get away from that unless you go under. And most tall guys are not used to rolling under shots.
Adam Stewart searching for a seam here.
dropping the body weight on him, using that size advantage. Smart move by Stewart.
And Stewart has been all over with his weight. Like we said, played college football, was up at 290 at one point.
Yikes.
Down at 234 his last couple of fights. I asked him about the Bridgerweight option. He said, no, when you get down around 220 for him, he becomes too small. Doesn't like the way he moves. So this is a decent weight range that suits him just fine.
Stewart's having a little bit of a problem overextending himself. He's coming in with his jab and his right hand falling forward. You saw him just kind of clash heads together there on the inside. Every combination leads to this, a tie-up. And a lot of time that's just him overextending himself.
Trying to find some action out of the clinch. Both fighters looking for a seam to capitalize with less than 30 seconds to go in round three. And there's a right hand from Stewart that connects.
That was a nice adjustment there from Stewart. He caught the shot and he fired right back. Little catch and release, catch and shoot. Little walk off right hand to end the round.
This is the first bout before the bell. As we take a look at some of the action from the Phoenix native Adam Stewart in round three.
Davey had some success with the left hand early on in the round, but Stewart was just busier that round. There you see the double jab. He had a couple of nice right-handed tents. There was a really nice counter off of one of the overhand rights from Davey. All in, it was a good round for Stewart.
There you see Adam Stewart's corner. Dan Moret, beg your pardon, is his gym partner. His head coach, Alan Viers, has been away. He's actually been in the hospital with his wife since Thanksgiving, and she's fortunately battling a fungus in the brain. We send our best wishes to the Viers family. But Dan Moret in Stewart's corner as we begin round four here on Before the Bell. Scheduled for six, and Stewart falling into a bit of a rhythm late in the third round. Trying to continue it here in the fourth.
He is, but guys, I think Davis, the smaller man, has to use his speed. When Stewart throws one jab, he's got to reply back with twos and threes. He's surely the smaller man. He's the quicker man. And although he attempted an overhand right the round before, he needs more of that. Surprising shots like that, the bigger man will take just a split second longer to see it.
Excellent point. And to prove that point, there was a nice little left hook check shot by Davey that caught Stewart coming in. Yeah, and I agree, Josh. I mean, he's more athletic. He's moving his head really well. He's changing levels. And he's got those tricky shots that we saw immediately in round number one. They've just been too far and too few between.
Yeah, for sure.
Davey coming in again. And Stewart blocking him up. Smothers him with a right hand. Each time, Stewart trying to encroach Davey with the correct movement here in round four.
Now you can see, Davey knows what he's doing in there. I think this is going to be one of those fights where he looks back and said, I had a lot more opportunities than I took advantage of.
Deep into round four now, though, Chris. He has to do something. There's only two rounds left.
Yeah, I would believe he's being a pretty deep hole at this point. Stewart hasn't done anything spectacular, but he's been consistent.
A looping right hand catches some air from Stewart. And the time is now to act for Alvin Davey. There he connects with an overhand right. That's not going to be ruled a knockdown. And Russ Milton says he tripped. But like you mentioned before, Josh, The crowd playing a factor here. You're a hometown guy. They see that type of action, and they respond.
For sure. And good insurance. He's feeding on the energy. He's using it.
And he triples the jab up against Alvin Davey. Adam Stewart aiming for his third straight KO. His ninth win, or his ninth KO overall. Check that. Right uppercut landing on the body from Davey. But again, like much of the action so far, fighting at close range in the middle of the ring here in round four.
Ooh, good jab there by Stewart.
He's found a home with the jab when he's thrown it. May not be throwing it as often as he'd like, but a lot of them have landed through four rounds. We see some of the action from round four. Josh, what stands out with what Stewart was able to do?
Again, he was just more successful with the jabs. He stepped in, he took more risks, you could say, and it paid off. Not everything is landing, but the crowd is screaming. If you're judging it, it makes you think he's winning. And it's to an extent, it's having an effect. Davis needs to be more active, in my opinion. Loop those surprising hooks that he's got. Show a bit of... like he's a smaller man. He's going to be a bit sharper than the bigger man, so he's got to show a bit of that to me.
Yeah, the last two rounds, I feel like Stewart has been putting a lot of things together, winning those convincingly. The first two, obviously more get-to-know-you rounds. I also had Stewart taking those first two as well. Now the time is now to act for Alvin Davey as we head into rounds five, maybe six. This is scheduled for six between Adam Stewart and Alvin Davey, our opening bout here on Before the Bell.
If I were in Davey's corner, I would be a little concerned because he hasn't pushed the pace in a way that would make Stewart be tired in these last two rounds.
As Stewart says that he plans for this to be his final six-rounder. He plans to go up to eight rounds after this. He has title aspirations in this division, believes that he can do it. And we've seen the big athletic heavyweight capitalize on his long reach through the first four rounds of change.
And that's one thing I don't want to take away from Davis. It's easier said than done when a bigger man like Stewart is walking you down constantly, making that big ring feel like you're in a phone booth. It's very, very hard. It's difficult. Davis has got the right movement. He's trying to stay out of the way. But again, I wouldn't take away from it. It is very, very hard.
Excellent point. And from this vantage right here, you can really see the size difference between the two. Stewart is a big, strong man. And he's controlling the center of that ring.
What's an alternative approach for Davey to perhaps go with when you see this hulking 6'6", 234-pound heavyweight coming straight at you continuously?
I think you need to add feints in. When you add a feint, it's going to make him freeze. It's going to make him hesitant. And when he hesitates for that split second, it gives you time. It buys you time. You get to move or you punch. The speed that he's got, he can flick out the odd jab. And like I said earlier on, reply back with twos and threes. Again, easier said than done. We're up here with a mic. We're comfortable. We're smiling. We've got food, but he's in a real fight.
Got some blood from the nose of Davey. One of those lead left hands from Stewart. Caught him earlier in the round. Drew blood.
And a left hook. Grazing Davey. Less than a minute to go here in round number five. Double up the jab and trying to apply the right hand to the body of Stewart.
And Stewart is replying himself very nicely, guys. He's taking the opportunities that he's getting. He's jabbing. Gotta be careful, but he's starting to put the punches together.
Those wide-ranging right hands from Davey mostly missed so far throughout this opening fight.
Yeah, but Davey's still showing that he's a threat. He's still throwing those bombs in the middle of the punches.
You still have to be careful. You have to watch out for them, for sure.
I really like Stewart's jab. He's doing a nice job these last couple of rounds, finding his range, flicking it, using some speed, even for the bigger man.
And there's another one that lands.
And Chris, I might say, Chris, I don't know about the jabs you're talking about, but the results is in Davis' face. The blood is there. Mm-hmm. The evidence is there.
That's easy for guys with microphones to point out.
Yeah. Exactly. Exactly.
We're through five here in this opening fight.
Very.
Here we sort of see some more work from Stewart as he comes forward. See the shaking of the head from Davey, which generally means that things are getting through. But also, we got blood on the face that round, so we know some of those shots, one of those right there, is doing some damage. Adam Stewart having a good last few rounds.
And Chris, when it comes to it, you're going to say, who pushed it harder leading to the end? You can say, we're seeing Stewart is taking things into matter. he's actually trying to force the pace. He's trying to make something happen. And that's what it comes down to, because three runs in, we said, look, someone's got to take hold of this fight, and Stewart is stepping up.
Absolutely.
He's been the effective aggressor, and he has one more round to try and do some work here against Alvin Davy. Sixth and final round coming up here in our opening fight on Before the Bell. Coming up next, Elijah Garcia, Antonio Hernandez. Another six-round fight at the middleweight division. And then the main card beginning at 8 p.m. Eastern. We see more of that jab from Adam Stewart.
Stewart's coming out in this sixth and final round, really stalking his opponent. Looks like he wants to get him out of there. Keep that KO streak alive.
Stewart hunting for an opening.
One thing about a nosebleed, it forces you to breathe out of your mouth, which is very dangerous. Getting hit with your mouth open is easier to get dropped or get injured or hurt your jaw. So that's something to think about as well.
Subsequently, a wise choice would be going to the body then if you're their opponent, correct?
Yep.
It would be. I don't think Stewart has thrown more than just a few body shots all night long. I'd be surprised if he started with 2 minutes left in the fight, investing in the body.
Adam Stewart finding a lot of trouble as a youngster. Spent some time in jail, found boxing, a true calling. Found the father figure and his coaches with boxing as well. Trying to make a knockdown. Davy here in the sixth, and that one certainly a knockdown. No dispute about it.
Chris, you mentioned earlier on at the beginning of the round, he came out. He said, this is it. He wants to add to that KO streak. You saw an example of it right there, where he came out hungrier, put the punches together. Good count on the right hand.
Davy gets up. Stewart has 1:05 to go to try and end it early and pick up another KO victory.
Yeah, you see Davies on unsteady legs, trying to get away from his opponent. Adam Stewart really putting on the pressure, running out of time though.
Stewart remaining calm, coming forward, and Davy able to back away. And a knockdown here in round six for Adam Stewart. It has been an impressive showing for him in these latter rounds. Right hand misses. Davy backing up. Needs to be careful. 30 seconds to go.
Blood coming from the nose and the mouth of Davy now.
And Davy.
That
will not be ruled a knockdown.
He's buying time.
Yeah, I was just going to say it took the words out of his mouth.
His face is bloodied. With 10 seconds to go, he would love to use some hyperspeed. He's running away. Stewart. Trying to make him pay.
But, oh, man, he wanted that KO.
Much like the early rounds here, at close range, that's where they end, but not because of anything that Stewart was doing with his approach. Alvin Davy had enough. He spits out some blood at the end of round six. Stewart saying, hey, what can you do?
Yeah, I tried. He went for it.
Yeah. Literally.
He could have started earlier, but that sixth round, he really came out there looking for the KO.
So Adam Stewart with an impressive showing in front of his hometown fans, his family, and his friends, winning those last four rounds convincingly. And for Alvin Davy, showed some good movement, showed the quickness, but the bigger Stewart, a little bit too much, like we said in the latter rounds here, rounds four, five, and six. And for Adam Stewart, when he was playing college football, he got kicked off the team, lost his scholarship because he continued to fight. He was working at Pizza Hut. He was working at a dog food factory when the show All American Heavyweights came calling. It's a show that found some big former college athletes with the goal to turn them into some heavyweight fighters. And that's how boxing came to Adam Stewart. Let's go down to Joe Martinez for the final decision.
Well, Fight fans, after six rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. All three see it 60-53 in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. Phoenix's own All-American, Adam.